Camp Consequence is nothing like it on the planet, nowhere. When these kids drive into our facility and that gate shuts behind them, they're mine. I'm on a mission. I believe I'm on a calling. I believe that this is what I was put on this earth to do. Nothing else.
Across America, there's a booming industry worth over $2 billion. It claims it can remold children and save families, often using controversial techniques.
You feel that pain? That's the pain your mother feels when you disrespect her son.
When you decide you want to do what I ask you, you can go back to bed. Do you understand me?
Every year, thousands of children, some as young as five, are sent away to camps and programs because their parents believe their behavior is out of control.
I was getting calls from school, he was being suspended.
You know, if he doesn't get what he wants, he freaks.
Children are often escorted to these programs against their will.
We've actually had children jump out of a car on a freeway, going down the road to escape.
They're kept there for weeks, months, or even years, often at great expense.
These children cannot leave unless they choose to run away. And even if they do, they will be retrieved by the police and returned to the facility.
Many programs are run by charismatic individuals who believe they're battling a fundamental problem at the heart of modern America.
Our kids are running the world, not parents.
If you spank your child, that kid's able to dial 911 and have your parent arrested for child abuse, why would you give that child that power?
But do these programs work?
The change in his behavior has been pretty slight.
Probably 50% of my boys have come from another program.
I got baby Jay over here, or Jordan, come back.
You'd quite happily send him back if you thought it was required.
Oh, him and 10 of his friends, heck yeah.
In a compound next to the local prison is Camp Consequence. It's run by former U.S. Marine Glenn Ellison.
We laughingly call these kids Al-Qaeda. When the enemy is in your house, it is a scary place to be. And that's what I deal with every single day.
Turn around, put your hand behind your head.
33 children, some as young as seven, are being handed over to Glenn and his team of volunteers.
Move! Now! Get your hand out of your pocket and stop your whining.
None of these children have been sent here by the courts. Most have been brought here without warning by parents who fear their behavior is out of control.
Spread your legs. The behaviors we deal with is mostly just rebellion. They just don't want to be told what to do. Every one of my kids are good kids making bad choices. They will be treated like a juvenile delinquent.
Yes, sir. No, sir. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
That's kind of scary, but that's what we want.
Glenn has been running Camp Consequence for the past 14 years. Around 300 children get sent here annually.
I don't know what this is. I don't know what's going on.
And what did you think when you pulled it? Pass through these gates.
I know they tricked me. I just can't believe they did it like this.
Camp Consequence normally runs for 1 weekend each month. But once a year, Glenn holds this special 30-day long behavioral camp. It costs parents nearly $2,000 to put a child through this.
I want everybody to listen up real good. Now, you got a choice. Your way or our way. That's the only two choices you got, but I promise you this, guys, you've never met a man on the planet more determined than I am.
I'm the guy who got kicked out of college, who had one dream in life, and I didn't quit. I didn't give up. I did whatever it took. I will win. You don't want to take me on. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
Children can't be sent here unless parents first attend a weekend-long empowered parent conference led by Glenn. Parents must also agree to attend Camp Consequence themselves.
Okay, listen up, families. I know that you're all concerned about what's going to happen this weekend.
It may be tougher on y'all than on the kids. If at any time anybody wants out, raise your hand. We'll stop what we're doing. We'll take your little darlings to the car and you can leave.
Where most programs, you drop your child off, drive away. I won't let anybody do that. I didn't mess up your kid. You're going to stay with your kid.
Our goal this weekend is for your children to clearly understand that if they think it's bad at your house, wait till they come to my house.
All right, camper, listen up.
As the parents watch on, the children are put through a process Glenn calls shock and awe.
Push your position, everybody, now!
Come on, get on the ground. I don't care if you're crying or not.
You like this by being abusive?
You might
hold it. No, get down. Push up.
This is a technique that Glenn has adapted from his time in the military.
Keep going.
Oh, you like lying and stealing, son?
No, sir.
Why are you lying and stealing?
Really?
You don't use bad language. It is not cool.
This exercise has a very important purpose. It's causing them to get tired, fatigue. So honestly, I can see what kind of kid they really are.
We got a problem, boy?
Yes, I do, sir.
What is your problem? On your feet. You are not going to use any foul language here. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
You better understand that.
I understand completely.
Push your position.
And what is your problem?
On your feet. I said you are not to say anything unless I speak it to you. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Up. You better knock off the attitude right now, my boy.
Right now.
Right now. Right now.
You're not going to win here.
You haven't got a clue.
Have fun with you.
Oh, thank you then.
Hey.
Have as much fun as you want.
Hey.
Whip me in chains. Attack me. Kill me if you please.
Hey.
I won't mind.
Hey. Listen to me. It's going to be a long summer with that attitude. You can do it my way. Because I've never lost. I will not start this weekend, son. Or you can calm down, and life will not be so bad. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
You do everything we ask you to do. Everything. And you'll get through this summer. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
Girl, pull the line right here. Now. You've been yelled at, made to do things you don't want to do, it's over. Ain't gonna happen again. No more yelling. Because it doesn't change behavior. You gotta want to!
You will not be looking at your parent at any time this weekend. You will not communicate with them any way. If I see you, and I will be watching you every step of the way.
You hear that, Mr. Bryce?
At just 10 years old, Bryce is one of the youngest children to be sent to Camp Consequence.
The main issues with Bryce is just disrespect and defiance. So I got to a point to where I was getting calls from school, he was being suspended, and I didn't want it to progress worse. We recently went on a vacation, and he was yelling F words, F this, from across the pool, and we were kicked out of the hotel. I found this through a friend whose sister-in-law had also come to this program, and one of his therapists has already referred two of her other clients to come here.
I just wondered how you feel about putting your kids through this experience that some people might think is quite extreme.
I think it's extreme that a 10-year-old ruled my house. That's extreme. These people are not touching my children. They have not put one hand on my child. They have not physically or demeaningly said anything to them or physically harmed them at all.
Not every parent seems comfortable with the camp's methods.
We didn't know that the camp was like this. We didn't, we just didn't expect all of this. You feel like they're violating your, you know, parenting. Not that we've done so well ourselves. You know, that's our kid. So, it's hard to see somebody else yelling at your child like that.
But Glenn is confident that all the parents will be won round by his methods.
If they took the time to really check out our website, They will see endorsements of sheriffs, state attorneys, public defenders. We are well respected in our community. And keep in mind, I've been doing this 14 years. This is a lot of kids been through my life, and we've never had one hurt.
It's 10:30, and it's supposed to be time to bed down. But not everyone is playing ball.
Yeah, I can't make you get in that tent. But I'm gonna tell you something, it makes for a long night. Do you hear me? Get in that tent, you go to sleep.
Get some sleep. Button it up so the mosquitoes don't get in.
Yep.
Or not.
Do you know why you've been brought in here, Bryce?
Disrespect. Not listening. Fucking back.
What are you feeling right now?
Mad.
In the middle of the camp are two piles of dirt. Those who refuse to comply with camp rules are assigned the task of continually moving the dirt from one mound to the other. After refusing to go to sleep, Bryce is sent to join them.
Get over here. Come on. When you decide you want to do what I ask you, you can go back to bed. Do you understand me? Or you can be here all night. I don't care what you do. But you're going to give me what I want. And you better understand that, little boy. Go to work.
He's refusing to get in his tent. He can certainly do that. We live in America. So we'll see how long he wants to be strong-willed, but it's totally his choice.
It's now just turned midnight, and Bryce has joined boys who've been working here non-stop since they arrived 5 hours ago.
Come here, boys. I want to talk to you. Are y'all mad at me?
No, sir.
Y'all ready for bed?
Yes, sir.
I'm not. I'm not going to let you go to bed because you were defiant. And when you get tired, the rest of them can go to bed. Because you're the ones going to keep them up. You're not going to win, little boy. I'm tougher than you. When you leave here, you're going to get in that tent. Am I clear? Go back to work. Go back to work, boys.
On America's West Coast, off-duty security guard and former Marine Sarge is assembling the latest group of children to attend his drill weekend.
Three simple words, sir, yes, sir.
Sir, yes, sir.
Sir, yes, sir.
Sir, yes, sir. Sir, yes, sir.
And you still can't get it right.
For the last 10 years, children from some of LA's poorest neighborhoods have been sent to Sarge by parents who fear their kids are heading down the wrong path.
When we first started this program, we started from 14 to 18. And we realized that 16, 17, and 18-year-old kids, they're already dropped out of school, got gang tattoos, doing drugs, making more money in a month than I make in a year. And it was no turning them around. And I realized I need to start at a young age. And we dropped our age to 5 to 14 and a half. We got to catch these kids young.
If you can do everything I just said, just like that, with no problem, why can't you listen to your parents?
We can, sir.
But you don't.
The majority of children in Sarge's program come from single-parent families and live in communities where gangs and crime are rife.
In today's society, when the male role model is absent, the kids lean to that gang member who has that strength, who has that authority in the community, who has that lifestyle.
Sarge grew up in similar circumstances in the Bronx, but having found salvation in the US military, he wants to offer these kids an alternative role model.
Over the 10,000 kids that have come through my life, I'm blessed to say all of them want to be like me.
Elijah, go and put that ball away and get in the car.
Across town, single mom Danielle is concerned about the attitude of her 8-year-old son, Elijah.
Really? In the car?
Yeah.
And I asked you to put your jacket back on because now you're going to be rushing to get out. Everybody from his father to his uncles to my cousins, you know, are incarcerated or dead or, you know, have had really hard lives because they didn't learn early enough. I want somebody to, you know, tell them how it is and no sugarcoating, you know, and show them, like, you cannot just do whatever you want when you want to do it.
To address this, Danielle has decided to sign Elijah up to Sarge's program.
Two people to a seat, you understand?
Sir, yes, sir.
Move. Sir. Hurry up! Hurry up! Hurry up!
No, stop crying, both of you.
Tyler, stop.
What you crying for? What?
He said it's painful, sir.
What's painful?
The juice, sir.
Suck it up.
Yes, sir.
When you cry, it's only water coming out of a socket. It don't mean nothing to me, and I let him know that. So you can cry, you get that sympathy from your mom, you're not gonna get it from me.
You don't look up until someone's talking to you, you understand?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
With their parents having signed over legal custody, the 17 children, including Elijah, are now under Sarge's control for the weekend.
Kind of scary. You don't know what can come. I don't know what it feels like to be away from the people you aren't really connected to.
This weekend, Sarge will put the children through 52 hours of forced marches and strenuous discipline drills. Tonight they'll sleep for just 3 hours. All of this will be guided by Sarge's simple philosophy.
You're going to learn to feel the pain that your parents feel. And when you don't like that pain anymore, you will stop giving them that pain. And when you stop delivering them that pain, you'll be the better child that they want. You understand?
Sir, yes, sir! Sir.
Push-ups begin.
You better get a little bit louder. I will not.
Be disrespectful.
I will love. My parents.
My parents.
Why are you stopping? Get moving. Give me all you got.
Keep your mouth shut.
Discipline. That's something that these kids are missing. If I was the president of the United States of America, every kid out of high school would go through boot camp.
Timmy, hold your head up. Straighten your back out. There you go. Let it out. Let it out. That's what I want to hear. Let out that anger. You disrespect adults. You don't pay attention, and you don't listen to what you're supposed to do. Mountain climbing, son. Right now.
What do you say to people who might watch what happens at drill weekend and think that it's aggressive?
You see something you don't understand? We're doing something wrong? Yeah, we make them hike 15 miles over the course of 52 hours. So what?
Let it out. Let it out.
We don't put our hands on the kids. We don't kick their behinds. We don't choke them out. We don't put bruises on them.
Straighten your back out, son.
We're trying to save these kids from going to prison or killing innocent people for no reason, for drive-bys.
Elijah hasn't committed any crimes. His mom has sent him here to ensure he learns to do as he's told at home.
Squat. Oh, you're starting to shake. You feel that pain? That's the pain your mother feels when you disrespect her, son. It's supposed to hurt. That's what she feels. Do you want her to feel like this?
No!
But you make her feel like this. Do you like it?
No!
But you make her endure it. You make her have to like it because you don't listen to her and she feels this pain. But you don't care because you keep doing the same thing. Isn't that right?
Yes, sir.
It's going to change, isn't it, son?
Yes, sir.
Squat lower. Now, you don't like doing homework. Squat. Hoorah.
Hoorah.
I hit a bump.
I hit a bump.
I will not fail.
I will not fail.
Hoorah.
Hoorah.
Discipline.
Discipline.
Respect.
Despite having children as young as 8 years old in his care, Sarge kept the entire group up until 4 a.m., carrying out discipline drills. Now, after just 3 hours' sleep, they're back on the march.
Go, go, go!
My feet hurt, my back hurts, we're not gonna sleep very long. Sometimes I don't even know what time it is. I miss my mom, and I miss the people that used to be around me. I wish I could be at home right now.
For Sarge, drill weekend isn't just about pushing these kids to their physical limits.
What's going on in your world, son? Why do you have a problem respecting adults and listening to what they say? Is it because that you're always around a bunch of women and you're the only boy and you think you're just running things because you're a boy?
No, sir.
So why do you do it with all the women? Because you don't do it around the
For the next 4 months, while the parents attend parenting classes, their children are entrusted to Sarge every weekend. It's a trust he fully believes he's earned.
You know, we've been doing this for, like I said, for 10 years. We got recommendations and letters from the State Senate, Boy Scouts of America. We're endorsed by the Department of Children and Family Services. We're endorsed by the Juvenile Court. We're endorsed by LA County Sheriff's Department. So it's not like we're a fly-by-night organization. How can I be doing something wrong? The community honored me as a father of the community because these kids look up to me and respect me. Yeah, they get a little dirty, so what?
While Sarge's program is endorsed by the LA authorities, there's no federal body to regulate and monitor the quality of care in the child intervention industry. Across America, there have been thousands of allegations of abuse, particularly in isolated and remote programs. Several have been shut down, and a thriving network of camp survivor websites have sprung up.
There's been a lot of discussion about this industry, and more all the time, as it becomes more and more lucrative. And it's really got to be investigated. And I'm not saying that all programs are terrible. I've run into a few I think were very good. But I am representing now. Children, we're not children anymore. They're in their 30s. They're still having nightmares. They're still having flashbacks. They're still suffering post-traumatic stress for the terrible things that happened to them in these programs.
For parents who feel unable or unwilling to take their child to a program themselves, there's an offshoot of the child intervention industry that promises to do that job for them.
Families hire me who have out of control teenagers to extract them and transport them to a treatment facility or a boarding school that the families have chosen for their child.
Bullitt's company is one of over 50 child transport firms that operate across America. They take children from their homes, often against their will.
Between 500 and 1,000 families contact us a month.
I'm gonna pick you up at like 9 o'clock.
Our operation is nationwide. We go everywhere in the United States.
I'm not going!
Why do you?
Bullitt uses slick videos on the internet to promote his services.
The drugs talking, that's all it is. This is not your baby, all right? Take a deep breath. We're on the road to recovery, all right?
Tonight, Bullitt and one of his team are heading out of LA on a new case.
Me and Mike are going to Chicago tonight. Then we got to drive 2.5 hours to Terre Haute, Indiana to pull this kid out of his house. We meet the mom. She takes us over to the house. Ba-boom, ba-bang. We go in, we get the kid, and we're on our way to Missouri.
Hey, you think this kid has any weapons?
I hope not, man. I mean, that is a huge concern going into this case.
But how big is he in, man? Do you know that?
Don't know that either.
We're going in this almost blind.
Some programs can cost over $40,000 a year. Hiring a transporter to get a child there doesn't come cheap either.
Our range of fees is usually around $100 an hour for the team. And then the expenses are what the expenses are. We put it all together and we send them a retainer that has the entire amount. So the entire transport is $5,192.15. They send a bank wire for that amount and we're in business.
After flying overnight from LA, child transporters Bullet and Mike are meeting the mom who's hired their services.
First of all, at this moment, what's going on with your son?
He stays awake all night gaming, won't go to bed, and just won't go to school. And he's a very intelligent kid, and he knows that it's the law that he goes to school.
This will be the third time that Elizabeth will have had 15-year-old David transported to a program.
How do you feel about it if I have to handcuff him?
Just try not to hurt him.
No.
I'll cry, but I won't stop you. He's got to go.
And this is a grant of authority over a minor, which basically gives us permission to take him from your home to the ranch. So if you'd be kind enough to fill that out, I'd appreciate it. Once the parents signs this document, child has no say-so in the matter. That's the law. We try to be in and out in 15 minutes. The more time we're there, the more chance for escalation.
David, it's me. I've got some transporters with me, I'm sorry.
Stay put, please. Hmm? Stay still, please.
Okay. I'm gonna get your shirt, sweetie, okay?
Okay. I'm Evan, and this is Mike. And at this moment, you're in our custody, you understand?
Sure.
Okay, we don't want any problems with anything.
I think you're gonna go along with the.
We don't need to put the handcuffs on you, do we?
I'm not gonna do that.
And you're not gonna try to be aggressive?
No.
You're not gonna try to run, right?
No, I promise.
Okay.
Arthur, I will miss you so much again. You okay? I love you. I'll see you soon, okay? I'm sorry, David.
Sorry, bro.
How did you feel this morning waking up knowing what you were going to do?
Sick. Very stressed. It feels very wrong to not tell your kids that they're going to go away from you. Just really sad because I don't want him to be away from us. He's my son. I love him more than anything. This is the true definition of tough love.
Every year, thousands of American children like David are taken from their homes by transporters.
The parents are in one of the most challenging emotional states that they have ever been in their lives. They have fear of how the journey is going to go. Is their child going to make a scene at the airport?
Bullet has an unblemished track record, but the child transportation industry is completely unlicensed.
There's some cowboys out there that really don't know what they're doing, and they have hurt a lot of children doing this type of work by not being cognizant of all of the nuances and intricacies that exist. This industry requires a lot more regulation than it has.
It's 6 a.m. and the start of day two at Camp Consequence.
Let's go, get up!
Get out of those tents.
Let's go. Get out of there. Come on out of there. Go on out of there.
Let's go. Double time. Time.
Let's go.
Let's go.
The children are escorted out of the compound to begin their first task of the day, picking up litter from a public highway. Last night, 10-year-old Bryce found himself on the wrong side of Glenn. Today, his struggle with authority appears to be continuing.
Let's count them out. Let's go.
Don't want to count, huh? Just don't want to do it.
Keep doing it his way.
Hey, son. Is this going to be like the 10th episode last night? Huh? Quit doing it your way, son. It'll be a long day.
Just like the 10th episode, Mr. Glenn. Get up, son.
If you don't want to participate with us, I'll put you back to your tent. You can stay right there. What you can't do is go home. That's not your call. It's mine. You get to pick, Bryce.
I don't give him any sort of structure in our house, and that is all my fault. So I need Glenn to show me how to parent a strong-willed child, because I obviously don't know what I'm doing. It's the truth.
Parents like Jennifer attend Camp Consequence not just to observe. They're also expected to learn new parenting techniques.
Parents, your job here today, as you will be paired off with a group of children, not your own.
From the time that parent gets there on Friday night, we are coaching and teaching the entire weekend. It's actually an OJT, on-the-job training.
Make sure, parents, you give direct instructions. And if your expectation is not met, you are required to give a consequence.
Good job. Good job. There's plenty. They're just got to move the dirt. There's one right there. Right here.
Parents supervise the children as they clean up the local sheriff's gun range. This exercise also gives Glenn the chance to better understand some of the family dynamics at play.
Owen, come here. Are you the only boy in your family? You have it tough. I'll help you. It's hard being a boy in an all-girl house, but you'll be okay. And if you work hard this weekend, I'll take care of you, okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Suck it up. Your good parents, or you would not be here. The bad parents don't even come to me. They won't put up with me. But I'm no kids. Give them choices. Don't trap them in a corner. You don't trap a strong-willed person. They will fight you to the end. If you'll accept the coaching, stay around us long enough to, you'll see change, I promise you.
Nearly 24 hours after arriving, the children are sat down for their first hot meal.
Nobody told you to pick your spoons up yet. Nobody told you to do anything yet.
Inside Camp Consequence, everything has to be earned.
I teach parents, if you can't control Johnny, can you control his food? Can you control his clothes? Can you control everything he has that doesn't breathe? If you're tough enough to do that, Johnny will do exactly what you want him to do. Because at Camp Consequence, guess what Johnny has? Nothing.
Bullet and Mike are still on the road. They're being paid to transport 15-year-old David to a year-long residential program.
We gotta figure this, the logistics of this out.
You have this door blocked with this table right here. He ain't going nowhere. And then we have someone right there.
All right, this is nothing against you, David. This is just basic security measures.
You ever had someone try and escape when you've...
Absolutely. We will handcuff them to a chair, and then we'll handcuff their arm. So if they do try and escape, they're going to have to carry the chair with them.
And is it all perfectly legal to use handcuffs?
Absolutely. If it gets really serious, we have shackles for the ankles, we have a spit bag, and handcuffs.
How would you describe your day?
It's been long. And tiring.
Has it been stressful?
Yes.
What's been stressful?
Just knowing that I'm not gonna be home for a little bit.
And how are you feeling right now?
I don't know. I'm kind of sad.
For the girls, it's their last morning at Camp Consequence.
I want you never to come back, and all you got to do is mind. You do those things, you'll never see us again.
Yes, sir.
Good.
What the boys don't know is that their parents are going home too, leaving them here for a further 30 days for the boys' only behavioral program.
I know he's going to look at me and he'll do his please signal and can you take me home.
What sort of things has he done, or has he been
nothing
doing?
Major. I mean, he's just angry, and he'll go in these angry outbursts. You know, if he doesn't get what he wants, he freaks.
Okay, parents, let's get out of here. If you're not staying, leave. I'll take care of your kids. Leave. Parents, out of here.
I think they're shocked that I did this because I used to give threats and never follow through, and I followed through.
Is he now in Glenn's legal custody?
I guess, yeah.
All right, stop the waterworks.
Having been transported 370 miles from home, David is now in rural Missouri, the heart of America's Bible Belt. He's about to arrive back at Master's Ranch, the Christian boarding school for boys he left only 8 months ago.
Yeah, look at this. They're all waiting for you, brother.
The ranch is run by Pastor David Bosley.
Was your mama crying when you left? And what did I tell you last time? Don't make this woman cry again.
It costs $36,000 a year to send a boy here. Like most long-term residential programs, access to the outside world is heavily restricted. Mobile phones and the internet are banned. Their choice of music and TV strictly controlled. And phoning home is not a right. It's a privilege that must be earned. But this isolating regime is no guarantee for success.
Now, David's been here before. I've got like four guys, just same situation. It's like you said, there's nothing to be ashamed of. I got JT, something didn't click for him. When you're 15 and you're back in the world, sometimes it's tougher than you think. Can you put your finger on what went wrong this time?
Just not paying attention, just being stupid.
When you're young, you're
dumb.
Amen.
I know the Bosleys well. I sold my home. I gave up everything I have to put my sons in their care.
Surely there must have been another alternative. Surely there must have been a therapist or maybe a psychiatrist.
We went to a counselor. We counseled with the school. We actually did some homeschooling for a little while. He was having some people bullying him at school. I realized the problem was more than a mother could handle.
But critics think parents' faith in programs can be misplaced.
I know the industry, and I know that the mantra is the same in all of them. It's a discredited mantra, and that is, if you force someone to do something, then that will straighten them out. Force has never worked.
With the boys of Camp Consequence now in his sole legal custody, Glenn sets them to work clearing ditches and fields in the height of the Florida summer.
Water is when you work. You're not working.
They're supposed to be here for the next 30 days, but as with all residential programs, the children have no control over the actual length of time that they may be kept here.
Just because your mom signed a contract for 30 days doesn't mean you're going home in 30 days. I can pull that plug in a heartbeat, and I will.
How do you mean pull the plug?
I can call mom and say he's not coming home. He hadn't earned it. He doesn't deserve it. You don't deserve him.
What do you say to those people out there that say the only people that have the right to take away kids' freedom are the courts?
I'm not about punishment at all. What I'm about is helping kids understand that in every society, if there's no rules, there's chaos. And that's just about where we are today in the world. Our kids are running the world, not parents.
Wanna go to the park?
In Pasadena, California, it's now 2 months since 8-year-old Elijah first returned from Sarge's drill weekend. Even though Elijah hadn't caused any major problems for his mum, Danielle, she sent him to Sarge as a preventative measure.
I wanted him to appreciate being home. I felt like he didn't. So for him to go for 3 days, he thought it was cruel and unusual punishment.
Elijah continued to attend Sarge's weekend sessions for 3 more weeks, but Danielle has now pulled him from the program.
Would you say you've seen any kind of noticeable change in Elijah's behavior since he went to the boot camp?
The change in his behavior has been pretty slight. I'm not gonna say he's like a whole new kid. He's still Elijah. I expect you to improve.
I'm trying to.
That's why we sent you to the boot camp in the first place, right?
Yes. I've tried.
You've tried what?
To be good. But sometimes it works out, sometimes it doesn't.
Danielle's decision is one that Sarge sees a lot.
It's heartbreaking to me because that kid we was reaching. And so we'll hear from him, guaranteed, we'll hear from him in a month and a half, 2 months.
What will happen?
I'm not going to let her in the program. We can spend our resources with someone who is serious about making a difference in their child's life. I can't save every kid. I can't make every parent do what they need to do in order to be a parent.
With their 30 days nearly over, Glenn is preparing to hand the boys at Camp Consequence back to their parents.
Right here. I didn't say look at your parents. Moms and dads, I present your new kids. I'm proud of them.
From here on in, parents are expected to attend weekly support meetings with Glenn.
You got a good boy.
What makes you do this?
I truly believe that they're worth saving. See, a lot of people give up on kids way too soon.
For some of the boys, it wasn't their first time at Camp Consequence. And for others, it may not be their last.
I missed you. I got it already.
Bryce's mama has got her hands full. he thinks that he can get away with anything, and he certainly uses his cuteness to his advantage. And he may have to come back, because I think he really believes that once he gets away from here, he's back in control.
We need to take the information that Mr. Glenn has given Mommy and the stuff that you've learned, Bryce, because you know they do Camp Consequence once a month.
Yeah, I know.
Yes, ma'am?
Yes, ma'am, I know.
Once a month. So if this continues to happen, do you know where I can send you 1 week in a month? We'll go to the beach.
Camp.
We'll hang out at Jacksonville, and you'll go to camp.
Was there any time during the last 30 days when you were worried about Bryce and concerned and...
Nope. I do believe that they had the best intentions with Bryce, whether or not he tried them on an hourly basis, which I heard happened quite a lot. So Bryce was like the dirt pile king.
I knew.
Do you think you'll go back to Camp Consequence at some point?
Maybe. And like... 4 or 5 years, maybe.
Why?
Because I probably will be hanging out with the wrong type of people.
Why do you think that?
Because I'll try to fit in.
All right, you guys are all about to get in trouble.
I ain't doing nothing.
We're not going to finish if you guys don't listen.
He's putting hats on me.
Stop yelling at me right now.
So you quite happily send him back if you thought it was required?
Oh, him and 10 of his friends. Heck yeah. If I have to get a dirt pile delivered to my house, I'll do it.